Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's ShotSpot Lou. Figured I'd send you a video or start out the new year with a dope-ass video. So today, what we're gonna do is turn this photo into this. We're just gonna add one of these old-school vintage filters to the photo and maybe mess around with the tone curve as far as making it a little bit darker. Adding in some texture. So, we already finished off this picture, now we're gonna start from scratch with this photo. So, right off the bat, you're gonna press Command J just to make a copy, or even if you don't really use Command J like that, take it, drag it, bring it down here, and it'll make a copy for you. Alright, so this is one of the homies I met when I was in Hawaii. Me and my boy were working out, and I was like, yo, son, there's no way you can be this freaking cocky for no reason and, like, not try to capitalize off it. So, I ended up giving him my business card. We linked up, we shot, and I was like, yeah, man, have fun with these photos, and, you know, hopefully you can start some sort of career out of it. And, yeah, like, that's what we're gonna do. So, anyway, thanks for Andy. So, you made a copy. Now, from here, are going to do, normally I would do the whole frequency separation and do all that, but my boy is good, he really doesn't need any of that. Now we go down to, okay, bang, made that. Then we're gonna make a new copy, and we're gonna still be on this layer. Click File, Place Embedded, and we're gonna use a photo that I got from Google. I'll go ahead and put a link to this photo down in the comment section as well, so you guys can use the same photo. Click OK. Now we just start scaling this out to fit our image. Let's see. I really don't want all of the photo used as a filter, so I'm not going to include all this. I'm just going to extend this out beyond the borders of the photo, just because I want these nice vintage lines right here. So anyway, it's in place. Click OK. And now deactivate that layer. So from here, the copy that we made, we're gonna go to Filter, Pixelate, Pointillize. And what this is gonna do is give it a little bit of texture. So for an image like this, we're just gonna stay at 3. Click OK. Alright, and if you press Z and take your mouse and hold on to Z and zoom in, you can see some of the pixelation that we did. So now we zoom out. Now we go back to Filter. We're gonna put a blur, Gaussian blur. And we're gonna keep it real low, 0.5. Click that. And now you can see the texture that's there. And now we go back to that layer that we deactivated, make it active, click on it, take that blending mode, and go to screen. Some people go to hard light, and then they like tone it down, but I don't like hard light, so I go to screen. Yeah, look at that. And at this point, you can still mess with the opacity, like depending on how strong you want it to look. You can also go back to background copy, and you can go to black and white, increase your reds, these are your highlights, your yellows. This is just for you to see how, you know, how it looks. You don't really have to really abide by this, but take this and go down to difference for the blending mode, and then you can take the opacity. I always take mine down to 10, and on top of that, I go to curves. And just if I wanted a little bit darker, just It depends on like the mood you're going for the photo. And that's basically it, man. So there you have it. So before and after. If you guys got any questions, feel free to label them down in the comment section. And I'll do my best to get back at you guys. Oh, look at that. You see this shit right here? It's still right here. So what you want to do, if that's the case, you go back down to it. You click Command-T. Just press it. Perfect. Click it. Bam. Easy. And that's done. That's it. Cool. So click, subscribe. Class is out for the semester for the next 2 weeks. So I'm just going to be trying to crank out some more videos, some more content. If there's anything in particular you guys would like to see, leave it down in the comment section below, and I'll try my best to look it up, study it, and put it out here for you guys. Cool. And once again, my Instagram is shotsbylu.1. You can find all my pictures and stuff there. Also on my website, shotsbylu.com. Dope.